Left behind more than 2 months after a plane crashed on I-75. For weeks, experts swarmed Southwest Florida to investigate the deadly crash from February. But now people who live near the crash site want to know why it's taking so long to repair the area. Wake News reporter Camila Pereira joins us live in the studio. And Camila, you talked with both neighbors and FDOT about what needs to be fixed.
And Lois, both say they want this sound barrier fixed. For one, FDOT says it's distracting for drivers, so they need to repair it for everyone's safety. But two, for neighbors, they say it will help them move on.
Every time a plane flies over Javed Kapadia's home, he's reminded of what happened on February 9th.
Seeing the black smoke as soon as it happened and just walking over there and seeing the flames, feeling the heat of the plane and smelling and tasting the jet fuel, I mean, that's something I'm probably never going to forget.
A twin-engine plane that crashed on I-75, narrowly missing traffic. Three survived, but the two pilots killed. Kapadia spoke with Wink News hours after that plane crashed, having been right over that sliced sound barrier as the plane was up in flames.
Just in shock. I'm still shaking to this moment.
He now shows us what the site looks like months later. Seeing the rubble, the cars, and pieces of the plane still left behind.
They're all pieces of the plane still.
And now the Florida Department of Transportation is working to repair that sliced sound barrier, but they say it's likely going to take more than just a few months.
There's roughly a 600-foot charred area, and within that area, at least 1.5 panels and maybe one beam need to be replaced. There's also an area of about 1,200 feet where we need some concrete cosmetic repairs. The process is going to take several months because we need to get specialty contractor bids.
FDOT says it's distracting for drivers, so repairs are needed for everyone's safety as this crash shook the community to its core, including Kapadia's home, heart, and mine.
Seeing a missing wall, it's easy to know exactly where that plane crashed. But yeah, once it's repaired, it'll help heal a little bit.
And now I did reach out to the National Transportation Safety Board, the agency that was investigating into the crash, about the pieces that were left from the plane still in the crash site. And they told me as soon as investigators finish the on-scene documentation, that's when they'll clean up the remaining debris left on site. Lois, Chris.
All right.